My case with Jack was an effort to try to prevent Nigeria from getting this foreign interference.
Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. Welcome back to Daily Happenings. How have we been? Hope we're good and hope we're having a really, really great time. Alright guys, if you're new to this channel, what are you waiting for? Please hit the red subscribe button below. Also, if you're returning and you've not hit the push notification bell, you can also do that by hitting the push notification bell on this channel so that you'll be the first to get amazing updates as we keep dropping each and every day. Alright, let's get to the business of the day. Now, Nigerians went on Twitter to actually call out the president of the nation, that's President Muhammadu Buhari, on the post he posted yesterday concerning the Igbos and Nnamdi Kanu, that he said it looked more like a threatening tweet to the citizens of the country, and many people didn't take it lightly. So the CEO and the founder of Twitter, Jack Dorsey, after seeing this post, actually went over to delete this post by the president of the nation. And the Minister of Information and the personal assistant to the president, Adamu Garba, didn't take it lightly as they went over to the pages to talk about this particular thing that Jack Dorsey did. And according to Adamu Garba, he said, "To those celebrating Twitter for removing our greatest general president's tweet, they should know that not even Jack, their president, and their epoch terrorist party ITP will stop Nigeria from ridding our country of a menace such as epoch and other criminals within our midst." Now, he dropped this post, and of course, you know, there are so many reactions from this particular post. Also, the Minister of Information also said a lot about this Jack Dorsey actually removing the president's tweets. And I'll be playing a video, because this is not the first time Adamu Garba is having an issue with Jack Dorsey. I'll be playing a video of the last time he actually had an issue with Jack Dorsey, talking about when he was going to place a legal case on Jack Dorsey so that he'll have problems with the government of the United States, and we have a problem with Twitter. And as you know, of course, Nigerians went over to mock him for this, his particular statement, saying, "Where does he want to take it to now? Maybe he's going to take it to the High Court or take it to the Supreme Court or wherever." So many mockeries on ground, but I'll be playing the video now. But I know you have a lot of reactions, you have a lot of comments, so please drop it in the comment section below. Also, if you're new, please subscribe, share videos to your friends, your families, or what have you, so that they will also get amazing updates as we keep dropping. Thanks so much, guys, for your time. I'll see you soon. Have a wonderful day.
My case with Jack was an effort to try to prevent Nigeria from getting this foreign interference, all those kind of international actors coming in the name of human rights to cause havoc so that you internally can self-destruct for their profitability and plunder. Most of them, they profit from our own instability and disunity. So what I did was to quickly hang a court case on his neck. Most of these publicly listed companies, especially the CEOs of those companies, the only thing they are afraid of is legal cases. Once you hang in a legal case on your head, they know that their chances of getting trouble with their CEOship position is threatened. And that is why, if you notice, as soon as that happened, he stopped tweeting about soliciting for the nation to continue to sustain the protest. To the best of my knowledge, that is a very big win to stopping him from playing the script they played in Egypt, in Syria, in Libya. So, to the best of my knowledge, I think we have won in this case. We've stopped him from interfering in our local politics. Therefore, it is time for us to call off the case from the court. So I have written to my lawyers to actually look at the possibility of withdrawing the notice of case court, and then so that we can now continue to watch and monitor him. If any of them again trying to do that, we continue with that case. But for now, I think it's time to say it's over. And but again, I remember during the protest, I caused so much anger, especially from our brothers from the South, because I say that the North is not going to participate in the protest. What I was trying to do is to deploy a military strategy of securing a site that is safe from contamination so that we can move to neutralize the site that is already contaminated. During the protest, the north is relatively secure, and that is why, for the first, let them stop from participating in the protest. Then we can now move to neutralize what is happening, especially in areas like Lagos. That's why I did that. It has nothing to do with tribal or religious or sectional consideration. It's just pure military strategy. But I know that so many of you are angry because of the way perhaps it's been misrepresented or misinterpreted. I want to personally apologize sincerely for the pain that I have caused you through, and I look forward to us to continue to unite so that we can build a better